Alrighty, so first thing you want to do here is fold the pool on over. That way we don't have to run so much strap out. It'll save time not having to roll such a long inflatable. It'll shorten the time. Alrighty, so if you have a lot of room to play with, then best thing to do is back this bad boy on up as far as you can. And then you don't want to get further than 50 feet because then your winch rope will run out. For smaller slides though, you don't really need to get back that far. I'll explain it all a little bit more in greater detail in a little bit. Another important thing though to remember is you want to line it up as perfectly straight on as you can with that thing. You don't want to be to the left, to the right, just try to go straight on. Alrighty, so now what we're going to do here is stake it down with super hammer powers. Let's see how fast he can go. Come on, you can hammer faster than that. Let's go. There you go. Good job. Alrighty, we got that bad boy staked down. Now we got the straps. Okay, so you can do it the slow way like him. And me, I just go on and toss it down. Pretty much on the very end, you want to stick it about arm, maybe wrist length through there. Maybe 4 or 5. That's about 6-7 inches. Just shove it in every, walk down every like 6 feet, shove it in hands length down there. And then at the very end, you're going to give it a little tuggy tug. Come on, let's give it a tug. Tug. Yeah, there you go. And then you want to do the same thing to the same side. And pretty much, let's pull these straps. You want to pull all the slack out, pull them perfectly even, and then we're going to have to put a little stake down through here. And if you didn't know, Matt's one of the world's fastest hammers. Let's see. Yeah, he's got superpowers. All right, so now we're going to turn it on. Turn a little battery pack on. And then you got a clutch down here, which lets you pull the winch rope out, like free spool or whatever, and then you can lock it. So you want to disengage the clutch. That way you can pull the rope on out. You're going to have to pull it down the whole length of the slide. Let's see how can you walk fast? Oh, he can walk fast too. Alrighty, now you just give these two little boy skis over here a clippy on. And then you want to make sure that clip it on just like that. Well, the two are facing opposite directions. That way you get an even pull on each side and it won't start rolling it all crooked like a rose shaped thing. Alright, so now we're going to lock the clutch back again. That way the winch will actually spin and roll this bad boy up. See, it's locked. Now look at this fancy wireless remote. You turn the wireless remote on, all you got to do is press the button. Well, let's get this thing started. So if you want a super tight roll, this is all the work that the only hard part that you're going to have to do. You don't even need to roll it up that much to start it off with. You can have it completely started for you. But let's press the button, turn it on, and watch the magic happen. Oh, look at that. Look at that. Now, if you want a crazy, crazy tight roll, you can walk on it while it's rolling it. And that'll put all your weight on it. And it'll press the vinyl down super tight. And it'll get the thing tighter than you've ever seen it rolled ever. But for safety reasons, I don't recommend this. Even though we have a synthetic winch rope, which is way safer than the steel ones. They don't snap back and kill people. Well, at least I don't think they do. And we forgot to put the little tie straps under here, so we're going to do that right now. But walking on the inflatable, if we would have did it the whole time, it would be the craziest, smallest, tightest roll ever. It's the magic. So let's get him back on there again. Press it down. Look how easy it is. You just walk on there. You don't have to walk on there. It's not necessary at all. I think it's kind of fun. You know, it makes rolling the slide fun and not super stressful and hard. Let's get that blower tube in there and square this bad boy off. Ooh, that's pretty good. You're pretty good at squaring stuff, Matt. So you want to keep pulling it until that blue edge is right on the bottom. You don't want to go over. If you pull it too far, then the little flap's going to get loose. Oh, let me rewind it a little bit. The reason why you wanted to scoot the dolly back a little bit is because whenever you're pulling the winch rope, you only have so much winch rope with the metal clamp right there. You don't want to pull it into the dolly. Sometimes you don't have that much space though and you have to scoot it up close. So what you can do is use ratchet straps for the first straps, then you can just shorten them, or you can use smaller like 6 feet long straps for the very front and then unclip those and then connect to the next ones. That way you can do it in a tight spot. It's a lot more work, but It's easier. All right, don't forget to turn the remote off. You need to turn the remote off. Oh, look how small and tiny that 14-foot slide is. That looks amazing. Alrighty, so now if you want to stand the inflatables up, you can put this through here like this, or you can just get a little metal clip or whatever. And then you want to anchor this bad boy. Let's see them hammering skills. Hey, so good at hammering. Alright, so you want to pull the cable up through here, put it through that thingy, pretty common sense. And then you want to hook it to the little strap right here. Now for your bigger slides, like the 22 footers and stuff, I recommend like wider straps than these, but it's only a 14 foot slide, so it'll pull it up there, no problem. Watch the magic happen. So easy. Look at this. Perfection. Bam, anchored there. Now you don't have to hold it with your hand when you're pulling back on the dolly. It's anchored there, so you can just use both hands to pull back. Look how beautifully easy that is. Oh yeah, good job, Matthew. Look at the water dripping out of there. All right, so we got a quick disconnect right here, and then if you want to charge it, this is super easy. So you don't have to unload the dolly, and all you gotta do is just take the little battery pack off. And what you're gonna do is the wall plug charger. You're just gonna plug it right in here. And then you want to make sure that the battery mode is on 12 volt, the cold AGM setting, because it is I think it's anti-glass something, battery completely sealed. Just make sure it's on that setting. Once you set it once, it should stay there forever. Well, I guess that's it. If you guys have any questions, just let us know, and you guys enjoy that dolly winch. Oh, this job just got so much easier. Have fun, guys.